You know, Psalm 145.
The Psalm 145.
I will read from 17 to 20.
17 to 20.
Psalm 145.
Psalm 145.
From 17 to 20.
17 to 20.
Are you there? Just read.
Amen. The Lord is unwaveringly righteous in all his ways, and gracious and kind in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call him, to all who call on him in truth without guile. He will fulfill the desire of those who fear and worship him with awe-inspired reverence and obedience. He also will hear their cry and will save them.
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I once, long time ago, taught you about holiness. I just want to say it again. Just write holiness. Holiness. You know, here, this issue that we have read concerning calling the Lord. If we read verse 19,
eighteen.
Just read 18.
The Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him in truth without guile.
In truth without guile is holiness. Is holiness.
Teresho,
verse 19.
He will fulfill the desire of those who fear and worship him with awe-inspired reverence and obedience. He also will hear their cry and will save them.
He will hear their cry. It means these are the people who consider the life of holiness. These people, when they call, God will hear them. Everybody who worship must call. If you worship an idol, you call an idol. You worship the living God, you call him. But the license of calling him is holiness.
Mara license ya ubicha modimo upila kibuketwa.
The law will hear them.
Morena uto will
bakwa. Look at verse 20.
Verse 20, ere. The Lord keeps all who love him, but all the wicked he will destroy.
The Lord keeps all those who love him.
Modimo lotola kamuka baba muratano.
Holiness without loving God is no holiness.
Bukhetwa kusa rati modimo a se bukhetwa.
If you love God,
how rata modimo,
you'll be afraid to offend him.
Utachaba kumukhopisha.
If you love God,
how rata modimo,
you will love him.
Utlo murata.
Do what he say.
Wadia kamukhwa bolelao.
There are four things that I want you to look on where we are
reading.
All these things brings forth the meaning of holiness.
In
other words, I want to tell you the meaning of holiness. Number one, is to set yourself aside so that you would have behaviors of pleasing him. That is holiness. You set yourself aside and develop behaviors
of pleasing him.
Number two is to represent him on his will. To represent him on his will. Number three is to overcome temptation. You know, most of the time when you are tempted is to make you to sin. And you get out from holiness. So now, if you overcome that temptation, it means you chose. After you have been given some options, you chose to do what is
right.
And the last one is to love him. Loving him is holiness. When you are called to the life of holiness, you understand that all his ways are righteous.
O thoma go ishotsela tsa ga e ka ofela na dilukile.
Including all his works.
Le mishumo ya ga e ka moka.
Partake in those things.
Jana go tsenela mo dinthong tseo.
You need to live a holy life.
O thoka go phela bo phelo bo bogethwa.
Not long I realized that.
E se galekele mo gele gore
whatever you are going through is to take you away from holiness life.
Di nya go re tusha ka ra bo phelo ba bogethwa.
If you love God, you respect him.
Ha o rata modimo na wa mohlompa.
If you love God, you fear him.
Ha o rata modimo ya moboifa.
If you love God, you stay in holiness.
Ha o rata modimo o dula ka ra bogethwa.
What is the reason why God wants you to be holy?
Why modimo a rata re ba bogethwa? Ka o bane yena mo ke moghethwa.
If now you do the difference, it means you don't fear him.
Arare ba ita zwo phomana na hezo zwi ambura ba muopi.
It means you don't love him.
Zwiambore aba mufuni.
By whatever we are doing, we are declaring God the way we know him.
Nga ndira ine ra ita zwithunga zwi sumbedza nga ndira ine ra shapa mudzimu vha ra fara mudzimu ngao.
Whatever the character we are showing.
Me kwaine ra shumtsumbedza.
What we chose to show the people.
Zera tinangela usumbedza vathuni.
Out of our situations.
Nga ngoma nyimere dzina ra vakhadzo.
We are trying to show God where we are.
Recording it to sumbedza mudzimu ro lengapi.
Or wicked life.
Vuchirone vokhetwa kana vhuvi.
And we are also telling God that God
we
don't love you.
Ari vafuni.
So holiness tells us that
zvino uva muketo zviamba uri
we love him.
Ri funa mudzimu.
And we fear him.
Futi ri yamopa.
In 1 Peter chapter 1.
Petro wa Toma chapter 1.
If we read from verse 15 to 16.
Ara langa bala 15 usvika ka 16.
This is the calling of God.
Ndimbidzo ya mudzimu.
Where God was saying, be holy as I am holy.
Musi mudzimu vachikore ivane vakhetwa nga uri nene mukhetwa.
Can you read verse 15 mama aloud?
Ara baleng verse 15 ri. But like the holy one who called you,
yes.
Be holy yourself in all your conduct. Be set apart from the world by your godly character and moral courage. Because it is written, you shall be holy, like set apart, for I am holy.
It is written, read it again, it is written.
It is written, because it is written, you shall be holy, set apart, for I am holy.
Listen to this, this is the scriptures of declaring us how we are supposed to be.
Lekeleng walo la uri bi re sontjo re be ka tselamang.
Sometimes we hear people say, as long as you know we are fellowshipping with God is fine.
Na go tshedi mota kwa motho as long as na ke na le kopana le modimo o fella mo lukile.
Our character counts before God.
Me gwa ya rena na ya ba ka modimo mo gwa wa rena ka mogore di
ntse. Set yourself aside.
Ngo ti tholo tebe ka thuko.
Tshele ba set yourself aside.
Tibie ka thuko.
What God is looking for you.
Ntwe modimo i lebele tshe mo wena.
Is to live a life that pleases him.
Gore wena o te o phile bophilo ba bo mogatha.
God wants you to live the life of pleasing him.
Modimo nya gore wena o phile bophilo ba o gatha yena.
And if you do that you will partake in his holiness.
And auka thoma wa dira seno o tatsenela ka ra boghetwa ba hae.
He has called you.
Yana ngo u biditse modimo.
Unto the life of holiness.
A u biditse bophilong ba o phila segaetwa.
And you are declared to live a life of holiness.
Mara jana wena o be ile uri to o phile bophilo ba boghetwa.
So you cannot call God without holiness.
Yana o ka se khone mo biditse modimo ha wena o semoghetwa.
Sometimes we need to check.
Na go tshedi ngore nthoka o thola.
If you say you are a Christian, you are a pastor, you are whatever.
Ha o ke re o ke pholoshitswe ke morote ke eng eng sona se.
Your life is different with what the scriptures say.
Go pila ga ha bo ka fapana le selentjwe la modimo le se bolelang.
Of what you are doing.
Ka nta o re o bere ka se se fu mo tia.
You are doing it in vain.
O ra ro diela le feleng.
I don't know if you're hearing me.
Nke tsebela le ntwa.
How can you say you are preaching the gospel when you don't respect God?
O ka bolela gore o rera evangeli ka mo sa thompe
modimo. You are preaching the gospel when you don't fear God.
O rera evangeli mara o sa chape modimo.
You are preaching the gospel when you are just insulting God.
O rera modimo ka mo ruwa ka modimo.
Holiness shows that you fear him.
Bo bontsho re wa ifa mrene.
I don't know if you are hearing.
A ke tseba le ntwa.
So you are called to fear him.
Tsana ngore bidi tsho re tere mo tshabe.
You are called to represent him.
Re bidi tsho re yemele yena.
You are called to love him.
Re bidi tsho re morate.
You are called to walk with him.
Re bidi tsho re tere sepile le yena.
Sometimes we must check our character.
Na go tshedi go tsontsho thola megwa ya rena bo phelo.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
I was reading Hebrews 12:7-17.
Na ke bala ba Hebrews 12:7-17.
I found some things that God want us to do there.
Ka thola di loche modimo ba ratang gore di re di dire.
If God want us to partake in holiness.
A modimo nya gore tsenelle ka ra boghetwa ba haeng.
There are things we are required to do.
Ona le tshe re thoka yang go di dira.
You are called to partake
in
holiness. So there are things where the Bible says when you are enduring discipline or enduring to be chastened, it's because you understand that he has called you for a certain purpose. So that endurance of being chastened is to understand that there will be fruits that pleases God tomorrow. If we read there, you will find these four things. Number one, the Bible shows that if you want to have to partake in his holiness, we must endure
the
chastening from the Lord. For example, he's not giving you what you want now.
Endure.
If you endure, it's for the best fruits you will produce. You are sick, but you cannot be healed. You are living a holy life and you are calling upon the Lord. Your endurance is to partake in holiness.
But
there are other options you can take. You can still go somewhere where you can be given something. But you still hold on unto the Lord. Because you don't want to defile yourself and affect fellowship with him. So therefore, any chastening from the Lord is dealing with us as sons and daughters. Whatever you are going through, it's just to come out to be a son and a daughter. The Bible says, the whole manifestations.
Bible ro bona gala ka moka.
The whole manifestations of sons and daughters are supposed to appear because the creation has been waiting. So there have to be a challenge on you to discipline you to come out as a pure son and daughter. So not all things you pray for you will
get.
If not, you are illegitimate. If not,
there is somewhere you are not going to endure. And God wants you to reach that stage. When you have this kind of education, if you don't have this kind of teachings, you won't survive. You won't be able to reach where you want to reach and survive. By the time when you reach there,
Satan,
the devil will play with you. You will search for other ways to search for answers to your life. So now God allows himself to channel you the way he wants you to be. I thank God you haven't got everything that you are searching for in life. God is still dealing with you. So that when you reach there won't be anything that controls your life. For you to get money can control you, or you control money. So now God will put you in a certain challenge and chasten you when you are there, and not don't give you things when you are there. And when you are fighting, when you are there, don't forget you have to be holy. There is a position where God will bless you. That position makes you to be uncomfortable. You don't get everything that you are searching for. If you can get everything you are searching for,
Na character yabo ye ngasibenga ndire ne baba vanga yozwi.
Even your character wouldn't be the way you are right now.
Baba ngasikono zura vathetsheresa
mungu. You wouldn't sit and listen to somebody talking to you.
Ngauri character yabo yo vipa vukuma.
Because your character will be very ugly.
Arali vasa bikiwa vado vanga chikuna chisikona.
If you are not cooked and you come out being uncooked, you won't be able to do what you are supposed to do.
Kama dozvi amba futi bome.
If you are cooked and you come out being uncooked, you won't be able to do what you are supposed to do.
So you must endure.
So usonjo khotelela.
Endure that chastening.
Khotelela ulukiswa
o. It might be dealing with your pride.
Ukaba ushuma nalo ugogomosha hao.
It might be dealing with your pride.
Ukaba ushuma ukushuma nalo ugogomosha hao.
The pride is gone.
Ote gogomosha o sepiche.
You represent God.
Ki gona uta yemela mudimo.
When we look at you we see God.
Hao tire u lebelela ra bona mudimo.
I don't know if you are hearing me.
Nketse balentwa.
There are some people by the characters.
Ona le batho ka megwa ya bona e.
You can question their Christianity.
O taba wa ipusha re khante puluso e jwang.
You can't see God in them, you question them.
A bona modimo mo bona ona o butshisha.
If I look at you I question you.
Ha ke le bela ke a ipusha.
It means there are some things you are doing.
O rona le lwa na lwa ntedi go wa di dira.
Fit you as a Christian.
Tedi sa o swanele jolo ka mopuluswa.
I don't know if you hear me.
A ke tsaba le ntwa.
So number 1 is endurance.
O khotelela.
Number 2.
Ya bobedi.
It shows that you must also fix yourself when by yourself.
Usonto te lukisa ka bowena.
Where you are weak.
Mo wena o kwa ngwe sina mata.
How can you entertain what is wrong?
O ka gathisa jang o bathabisa jang tshekele seng tsone.
Where you are supposed to sing.
Che di uisa moto sinya ngwe le teng.
If you are watching a movie.
How lebeletse movie.
And you know you are weak.
And what se bore o bukuwa.
When you read there you see nudity.
How bala wa wathola bangwadi lo re ba dula na go tshele ngwa ba apara. Kwa tswalela ntwe buwe.
You are fixing by yourself.
O lukisha ditaba cheka buwena.
But if you say no you will close one eye.
Ha uri ke tatsolla le thoka le letre.
You will be surprised you are inside.
O tamakala o tsene ka ra television.
Many times we need to deal with ourselves.
Han chiri thoka u shumana le borena ka borena ra te lukisha.
Can we stop blaming other people we deal with?
Wena u sola batho ba bangwe na u lebelela tsa go te lukise.
Satan always will check you on your weakness.
Mo Satan mitaye u lebelela uri bukuwa kai.
And try to attack you there where you are weak.
A leka wa thakana mo sineng matateng.
If you can be stronger there you will live a holy life.
A tiamo ta phela bo phelo mo
khe. I don't know if you are hearing me.
A ke tsebale.
Tell me say Satan always.
Is Satan
is checking where you are weak.
Wa thola uri bukuwa kai.
And try to attack you.
Mara u leka wa thakana mo.
Where you are weak.
Mo wena u leng bukuwa teng.
Can you fight him back?
U ka lwana le yena na.
By fixing yourself.
Ka u lukisha buwena.
That's where you live a holy life.
Ke wona yo ta khona phela bo phelo bo bogetwa.
You have got a right choice.
Ona le tukelo ya ugetha odi antwe icheng.
And you can see that this choice represents you.
And we are bona uri ndo uigethile nya u tsanela.
It does not represent Christ.
But
you say
Christ.
I'm not choosing it.
Ka ona ra wa ke igethi.
I don't know if you hear me.
A ke tsaba le ntwa.
You have got a right choice to be angry.
Ona le tukelo ya u dineya.
But you say no, this does not represent Christ.
Mara wa ndo ya u dineya yemele Christ.
I live a holy life if I do this. Na ke phela mo
ugetha hanga dia diloche.
I'm an old person.
A ura uri ke motho wa khale.
You choose what is right. And you do what is right. If you believe shout hallelujah.
Ke ure hallelujah.
Tell never fix yourself.
A go botse motho le ngafa go to lokisha.
How many of you want to fix themselves?
Ke ba ka ba nyaka ngo to lokisha.
You want to fix yourself.
O go to lokisha.
You will live a holy life.
O ta phila bo phila bo bogetse.
You will go to a place.
O ta ya tulong.
When devil knows that he has trapped you.
A satana na no ruse.
You turn there.
O re boela mara.
You turn on the road.
Wena o tshike tsela.
I can't reach there if I reach there.
Ke ka sa fita kwa le anga fita. Ke to palelwa.
That's how you will overcome Satan.
Ke ka mogota futlulang Satan.
Devil knows that if you reach there.
Satan what tsebora o ka fita ke we.
Ah you are finished.
O fedile.
If you want to see what is holiness to us.
Ha o nya go bona re boghetwa ke eng mo gorena.
It's a definition.
Ke thaloso.
Of showing that we fear and love God.
Ya o bontsha re re boifa e bile re rata Modimo. Ke yona tsela yeo.
It's as good as you have got children.
Ono sona le o na le bana.
If children they don't fear you, they do whatever they want.
Ba sa tshabe ba radia ka mogho ba ratang.
They just do whatever they wish.
Because
they don't fear you. If you want to see children fear you, there are certain things they will never do. Because also they love you. They say, if we do this, what about our father? I don't know if you're hearing me.
Amen.
So the definition of showing that you fear and love God is holiness. If you want to live a holy life, you also say, I cannot do this. Because I fear God. I cannot do this because I love God. But there's an opportunity for you to do the wrong thing. And you say, no, I cannot do that wrong thing. I fear God. If I do that thing, it means I don't love Him. I don't know if you're hearing me. I thank God because you're about to fix yourself. As you are fixing yourself, the Lord will be fixing your destiny. And He will reach your destiny. Number three,
Samurai.
Follow peace with all people.
Latela kucho le motho ka moka.
Is there that follow peace?
Latela kucho.
When you are in the church here, there are many people who are not coming because they are Christians.
Ah, una le ba u likereke una le thoba banche.
Don't lose your peace because of them.
Latela ke kucho ya gao ka lebaka la motho.
Peace that surpassing all understanding. You know, because this, the peace no one can see, it's inside you. It's not like materials that everybody can look. People question you, why are you still in charities? There's peace in you. There's no materials around you. There is peace that's surpassing all understanding. So there's nobody you are fighting. But don't lose your peace. That peace is a door to holiness. Because if now you have that peace, you won't utter a statement that will be questionable. You are afraid to lose the peace. You know, when you've got peace, you always smile. You know what devil normally do?
Nto I Satan to send him to idea.
He will give you money.
To offer chalete.
And a small money.
Over chalete nyan.
Just to take your peace away.
Orano to shakucho ya ham.
Devil is so he's so funny. This
Satan o kama khumwe.
He's so funny that he can give you small money.
Ako offer chalete na nyani.
And this money is to take your peace away.
Chalete na yaki ono to sakucho
ya ham. When you are there, the moment when you calculate, you realize He gives you that. There are some small blessings that come to us. They must not make us to lose that peace. I don't know if you're hearing me. Your challenges must never make you to lose the peace. People around you, their characters, how they react towards you, how they speak against you. How on earth you find people who are speaking about you and you find it's reaching your ears, searching for your peace? If it reaches your ear, you say, they spoke it there, someone bring it this side.
No.
Which means I'm a holy person. I cannot lose my holy life. This is there to make me to react in a wrong way. I don't want to lose my peace. I will hold my peace. I don't know if you're hearing me. So peace takes you to forgiveness. The last one is a root of bitterness. Be careful of root of bitterness. It enters your heart here and makes you to react and fight. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
And this root of bitterness makes you to be offended. There is no way you won't be offended. You are living with people to offend you. So be careful, clean your heart. Take care of your heart. Holiness is your life. I mean, you people who are married, you know each other.
liatsibelana.
You can help each other
lekatushana
to reach there. Don't have a root of bitterness. Don't pretend when things are bad.
Speak
it out together in peace. You can overcome and bring peace. You bring holiness in the house and the Holy Spirit will stay there. I don't know if you are hearing me.
I guess I'll
Tasso say, hey, I want to bring Holy Spirit in my house by living a holy life in my house. Allow your partner to correct you. Allow your character to be checked by your partner. Not long I was understanding that partners, they love to protect each other. Like Ananias and
Sapphira.
They love to protect each other. Like Ananias and
Sapphira.
If you call them, they stand together. And you tell these partners, you are not praying. When this one knows, it doesn't say yes. They look at each other. As if, what is it that he's saying? And when this one say, I pray.
And
even this one will say, I pray a lot. These are partners, they do like they don't help each other to achieve holiness. They are partners in Christ. They are sending each other to hell. If you read Proverbs
3:11,
my son, do not reject discipline.
Amen.
Or take it lightly. Why? Because the discipline makes us to learn out of our mistakes.
Amen.
I mean, if you want to live a holy life, don't hide your mistakes. Once bitten, twice shy. I mean, the mistakes you have committed must not come back again. And don't hold each other with mistakes. I don't know if you're hearing that.
Amen.
So let's check our mistakes. And
let
us not capitalize to each other by mistakes.
If I love you
and we love God, we can help each other out of our mistakes. I don't know if you hear me. We'll correct each other. When we pray, God will hear us. How many of us want to help each other than capitalizing? Some people just say, but I'm a Christian, I'm a better Christian. This one, if Jesus
comes,
this one, I will go. Why? There's a lot of problems. I'm better.
Yes,
52. Problems, I've got
problem.
10. I mean, all these problems shows that you
need
holiness is needed. Tell about holiness is needed. Listen to this. The Bible shows that here. Any discipline you get is to make you to be what God wants you to be. In Romans 6:22. I was reading this, I was shocked in this verse. It says, you move from sin and become servants, and which is the fruit unto holiness, and the end is everlasting
life.
You move from sin, you enter what?
Holiness,
and the end is everlasting.
It's a simple thing.
You move out from sin, and you enter a life of holiness. From holiness, the end is everlasting. I don't know if you're hearing that. I believe some people here will take decisions of understanding how they can enter everlasting life. Is when you move from sin, get out from sin, and enter holiness. Tell them, get out from sin. You know, I wonder, we are preaching holiness here. But I do wonder. We still have Christians who are sinning. I wonder, how can you be close to us and you do what is wrong? It shows you don't respect us. It shows you don't love us. If we are preaching the truth to you, it shows you don't love us, you don't respect us. You cannot do what is wrong and carry on doing. And we are preaching the truth, which is the holiness. That holiness, you move out from sin when you hear the word of God. You enter everlasting life. I will just read this verse and we close. 2 Corinthians 7:1. It says, having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and the spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. One of the things that makes us to live holy life, we have promises. Promises. When you are holding God, will make you to overtake all people who are in front of you by living a life of holiness. That's holy life. When somebody gives you wrong money, say no. Because it might be coming to take the right money. I don't know if you're hearing me. When somebody say, come here, we gossip, no. My mouth is to pray to the living God. When somebody come and tell you things which are wrong, you say no. I can't take things which are wrong because I want to use my ear to hear from the Holy Spirit. Can I say this to you? From today, check your life. Because of the promises that you have been given, if you live holy life, they shall come to pass in your life in the name of Jesus. If you believe, shout hallelujah. So promises are words that have been given prophetically. Promises are words you are given prophetically. You will drive this car. You will have this. You will have that. You will live there. Satan knows that by living holy life, you will get all these promises. What he will do, he will always disturb you. Always disturb you. Don't allow these disturbances from Satan. Whatever you are going through is from Satan, which is against your life. Hold on that holiness. Hold on your peace. You will make it in the name of Jesus. If you believe, shout hallelujah.